Ortiz ends up striking out. Second out of the seventh inning. He'll say some stuff on the way by, and he'll show Timmons where that pitch was.
Yeah. He's lucky he's still in the game. A lot of times you show up an umpire like that, and, you know, you're ejected from the game immediately, but Ortiz giving him that high sign on the 3-0 pitch.
Now somebody's gone.
Somebody's gone.
It's Big Poppy. And he is coming out to say some more. He'll be blocked on his attempt to come out to say some more. Pedroia trying to calm him down.
Managers can't really argue balls and strikes.
Wow. I don't think that phone's going to work anymore. It's like he didn't get somebody by mistake with those cuts.
Yeah, that's dangerous.
Moss did not try to go first to third. So Vogt has another hit. And now that's 6 runs for the A's. And Ned Yost is going to go to the bullpen. It's been a while since Ned has gone to the bullpen this early.
Yep, Jeremy just didn't have that location like he wanted.
Well, the umpire on the field said it was a swipe and a miss, right? So what did you see that would tell you the umpire on the field was wrong?
Jung Ho showing some emotion in the dugout.
Oh, wow. There goes the gum.
But at least from the angles that we saw, I don't know how you
even take the base hit away. There's only 3 inches difference between Butler and Davis, but Davis is rather long and lean, and Butler at 6'1" is checked in at 240. So they make the move, and look at Ethier. Get it out, son. One away.
Then Bryce Harper will hit it in the air to left. Jeff Francoeur, after switching over, makes that catch. There is something going on in the dugout.
See Papelbon saying run the ball out. And Bryce saying, you got to be kidding me. And then Papelbon went right after Harper. It's getting ugly, folks. There's no other way to put it. That stuff happens throughout the course of the season, but...
With Bryce Harper evidently nose to nose with Jonathan Papelbon.
That's not good. I mean, you could read his lips. He told him, you got to run that ball out. And Bryce Harper said, are you kidding me?
Ninja Turtles. Now, Jared Cozart, last time he was out there, remember, gave up a run on a ball that was almost a double play. When he returned to the dugout, he wasn't a happy guy. In fact, he fired his glove down and promptly knocked all the gum off the bench.
Yeah, knocked the bucket over with the bubble gum, tidying up in the dugout.
Jose Bautista. Frustration mounting, obviously.
This year, ERA under 2.
Fly ball to left, sending Santana to the track.
Oh, a little breeze would have been nice right there. A little carry.
Oh, man.
Didn't miss it by much.
And he knew he just missed it. It was July 12th of last year in Cincinnati. We hit a game tying home in the ninth and won it in extras. Jung Ho Gong catching, became the first Pirate to do that, and he's going to take it out on the cooler. Firing that cooler down there.
Yep, a little intensity there.
Yeah.
That's a good one right there. I guess in baseball terminology, that would be called a snap.
Yeah. Chip Hale said, been there, done that.
But that was a pretty good one.
That was a good. But, you know, that's the intensity of a hitter who knows that a lot depends on him and his success.
And I think he was probably frustrated at himself because it was a good pitch.
Oh, absolutely.
Probably wish he would have swung it.
Well, you wonder what pitchers do during the break between innings. Watch what Chris Sale does.
Well, they've given up 8 hits and 8 runs. This is what they do.
And he's not shooting a testimonial for the toughness of that ice chest.
Poor Cooler.
Yep.
Joe Walter pacing around a little bit. Didn't want to make this early call to the bullpen. Mike Wright on the frustration. Taking it out on the Orioles bench there. Yeah, it was a very disappointing start for Mike Wright. That first inning after hitting Batista and then the warning.